Welcome to our channel Sparkles College, and this is Sadaf Meher. Today we will be discussing about another organizational structure, which is matrix structure. Matrix structure is basically a combination of functional and divisional structure. Now if you look at this slide, this matrix is particularly explaining and showing the combination of functional and divisional structure. For example, you can see senior management, functional structure, production department, sales department, finance department, research and development department. Basically, functional structure. And then on the left side, production structure, which is explaining the divisional structure. Production manager A, production manager B, production manager C. Seen in previous slide, matrix structure is combination of both functional and divisional structure. That's why it requires dual reporting to two different managers. For example, an employee manufacturing product, let's say X, will have to report to the production department and also to the manager who is in charge of product X. Basically, the aim is to get benefits of both structures. If we talk about the advantages of matrix structure, the first advantage is, of course, to get benefits of both functional and divisional structure. This structure also supports flexibility. In today's time, environment is changing rapidly and we need most effective coordination in most complex situations. For example, a motorbike manufacturer may want to produce, design and market new model. Now this process involves most part of organization and flexible system is needed to achieve these objectives. Only matrix structure can support these objectives. Also, this structure supports customer satisfaction. Production manager could be replaced with customer managers, in which case the whole team will be focused on meeting the needs of customer. It supports teamwork, exchange of opinions and expertise. As far as disadvantages of this structure are concerned, dual reporting will lead to conflict and difficulty in lines of control, as team member will be answerable to the production manager and also to the functional head, which will lead to dilution of functional authority. Now, this conflict will require time-taking meetings to be resolved, which in turn will result in higher admin costs. That's all for today's lecture. I'll see you in next lecture. Till then, like, share and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.